Right, back again. Time to play more Factorio. But everyone here knew that, right? Who stops after 100 episodes? Who can just stop? And today we have fire. This is pretty good positioning, I think. I like the corridor of flame that roasts them. So today, our goal is molybdenum. Pretty shit. Oh, I cut power to this at some point. So all you are dead, right? That's probably bad. I'm probably counting on this somewhere, aren't I? Yep. Bots, prepare. This is easily fixed over in potato land. Yeah, like right here. So I know this is a line right here. And then right there. I guess right there. That's good enough. Now we're energized, right? It is good to be good. It is bad to be bad. I'm going to be turning off those, what is this? Oh, this is the salt line I put in, like, yesterday. I already didn't remember it. Alright, I need concrete. And then we're going to rough out where the molybdenum, processing will go, then we'll go fetch the ore, then we'll start building the buildings, then we'll put all that in place. We'll end up with two caravans, one for the magic seaweed juice, the other for plates, which go nowhere at my current tech level. That is not a problem whatsoever, because I will not be at this tech level forever. Right? This isn't forever, right? Oh no. But over here. So, we are going to slowly drag ourselves to the edge of our monster processing belt for all the different ores and materials that... Oh. Stand down, soldiers. The war is over. You can go home. How are we on... Oh, we got some logs. Let's do them all. Alright, good. That means I'm free with the grenades now. To show the forest what I really feel. Bam, bam, bam. It was just inspired, whoever came up with this idea. People complain clearing forests takes a lot of time and is annoying. I want it to be better. And then some absolute madman genius sat down and said, "Why don't you do it with grenades?" And someone looked at him and said, "That's not how grenades work." This person was fired. And now we have this wonderful scenario where I can just go in and I can solve all my problems with explosives, as it should be. I don't think anyone ever, anyone sane, real, could ever complain about a setup like this. So what I gotta do is make our next walkway. And we're gonna... I don't think we're ever gonna have huge niobium. So the line is gonna be dependent on... Bam! It's because I didn't want the log in my inventory. And now we're gonna have to clean these guys up too. Might as well, since I've already allocated the inventory space. And very soon, I am going to have to come in and clean up all of the old wall, the intermediate wall. I knew this was going to happen, but I also didn't have a way to hold the space while I was gone. Maybe I could have made it easier on myself somehow, but I didn't. Actually, is this kind of a good line, like right here? Because I don't think it's ever going to expand farther outward from this. Niobium's not needed that much. And when it does, I will doubtless be building elsewhere. So I think all of this is going to have to be rebuilt one day. So this is what I'm declaring the line to be. This is the edge of molybdenum land. No avoiding it, huh? I'm out of grenades. Again, a very un-American way to be. Is this... where are we? Yeah, let's go all the way south. Walkways make the factory. We will clean up this, which is a remnant of disordered and poorly thought through times. When I was trying to speed tank the all the biter nests, it didn't work. It didn't work at all. Only the wall of flame saved me in the end. Fire is always there. Alright, so what we're going to need to do now is we are going to actually belt in the molybdenum, because it's right there and I'm right here, and what else are belts for? Belts are fun. I like belts. So we're going to have a molybdenum line going in like this. And this, you know, come up to like here-ish, and I'll finish it later. And now what I got to do is I got to go down and get molybdenum going. Right now, it is not. Right now, it is... This is all kind of obsolete, right? Like, the idea of containing the pollution doesn't have to happen. So, what are we doing? I want to mine not on the belt, on the bus. And I've declared this kind of a bus, but it jukes down, so I guess right here is good. I had to juke down and then up because of biters, which is absolutely shameful to say, but unfortunately it's true. I kind of don't want to do this on the... I'm never going to use all of this. I mean, by the time I do, I'll have plenty more capacity, so don't worry about it, right? Just don't worry about it. All right, Godzilla. Where are you? Bam. Alright. Step one. Go to the snack bar. It's all about you first. Store food. Step two. I want you to go over... I don't think I've made a drilling things. Drill heads. Right there. That's the drill head, right? I think that's it. Yeah, that burner assembly machine is making drill heads. Alright, anyway, Godzilla, come with me. We're gonna go on a road trip, you and me. Get in my pockets, giant dinosaur. Factorio engineer is a wonder. So over here, we are going to make a caravan outpost for drill heads. Then later on, we're going to have to come back and goose him, because there's not going to be enough drill heads, and I'm going to want this moving faster. Actually, maybe I'll goose him right at the start. So this is natural gas, and it is good, and this is drill heads, and it is not good. So what I need to do... Oh, I suppose that makes sense, right? Pick this up. Correct, right? Maybe. Alright, caravan. Caravan Zeri. Two. There. And I just want three there, but three there. There. Drill heads. Alright, dinosaur. Your time is come again. The same dinosaur it is. It still has. This. Now I want you to add destination. That destination is right there. I want you to fill your cargo. I want you to add destination all the way over at the molybdenum ore, and I want you to empty cargo. And I'm going to give you a bit of food. Unfortunately, I can't do it easily. I'm going to give you a starter pack of food. And I want you to do this. That's where you are. You're going to fill that cargo, and it's going to take a while, so I'm just going to goose you. Probably don't need to fill cargo on this. It's probably kind of a waste. Whatever. Because it's going to end up with a whole caravan caravansary worth of drill heads in there for two miners, and a anxious dinosaur hovering over it with another 30 units of drill heads, all eager to shove it into the two molybdenum miners. Will there ever be more? Probably not. So this is almost certainly foolishness on my part, which I can constrain a little bit. Coming up here and just saying, here, only take two. And then he might have 30 in his inventory, but he could be repurposed. And we will sit here and we will wait for our dinosaur to... No, we're not going to wait for anything. We're going to start building belt. We have to get up onto this rail? No. We want to go on this side? No. We want to go up onto this rail? Yes. So what we'll do is upsies like this is. And we'll cut over on this side. And then we'll connect this over to where it needs to go. Ah, here we go. Dinosaurs here. Bam. Alright, drill heads out. Drill heads in. As I recall, it lasts forever. Oh, that's wonderful. This is so efficient. One, two, three. I'm not seeing the three a second mining speed, though. I'm seeing a mining speed. Well, it is. It's doing pretty well. Alright, this is almost certainly enough for now. Maybe I should put down more. Maybe it won't matter. I mean, it's going to be really simple to expand. Now, my goal is to use a line that isn't under a huge amount of competition. So, is the nitrogen line shared with anything else? Kinda right there. Looks like the answer is no. Nitrogen is a... High five, dude. Yeah, nitrogen is fine for double decking. And so I will do that. Plenty of food at the food court. Highly important I keep a handle on that. If I lose track of the status of the food court, I will get angry dinosaurs. And I think yeah, they would be totally worse than biters. I think yeah, that would be a big problem. Is ugly is bad. Not gonna clean the entire thing up. Just a little bit of a time here and there. That's enough. There. Clean it up a little more. And I'll keep doing that. Well. Now the thing of it is, I think I might have made a mistake. Molybdenum ore goes to powder. Powder goes to dust. Dust goes to pulp, needs water. Pulp goes to concentrate, needs nitrogen. Okay, I've used the wrong one. Because I'm going to have to double up on this. Alright. I'll make it work. So nitrogen's going to have to come over. And here we have the ore. Just a trickle for now. Because we don't, like, use it for anything. So it hardly matters. I mean, everything matters, but, you know. I don't think anyone's going to die if I do this sloppily. Alright, so we have nitrogen. No, that's not how it has to be. It has to be like this, because we need a nitrogen tap right here. Yeah. And we have nitrogen pressure, which is good, which means my nitrogen plan worked out. And we just have a solid stream of ore coming in, which I can increase at any time. Alright, so now it's time to talk buildings. I have jaw crusher, methanol reactor, advanced foundry. I still have this agitator. What do you even do? Oh, you're going to be used right now. I've been keeping this thing in my inventory forever because I made it by mistake. But here we are, we're actually going to use it. Alright, awesome. Awesome. Alright, so let's see what we're in for, eh? Molybdenite. Ah, oh, they can't. Just incompetent. Alright, jaw crusher. Jaw crushers we got. Takes 10, makes 5, makes it fast. And then that gives us the powder. Powder goes into. Yeah, right there. Now we go into dust in a ball mill. One jaw crusher supports one ball mill. And again, it produces a lot of output, though. No, wait. Oh, excuse me. One jaw crusher. No, wrong button. One jaw crusher produces 5 every 2. And then the dust takes 5 every 4. So we need 2 ball mills. One jaw crusher, 2 ball mills. Then we need an agitator. Unknown amount of agitation is required. No, just one agitator. Okay, so we need 2 ball mills so far. I already have the jaw crusher. I have the agitator. So, right there. Okay, we got agitator. Great. Now we go to here. Now we need a hydrocyclone. Unknown ratio. Gonna assume it's 1. So let's get 2 ball mills and a hydrocyclone. Ball mill. Bup. Hydrocyc. Oh, we can just build them right now. It's wonderful. All right, where were we? Oh, Molly. Powder. Dust. Pulp. Pulp. Concentrate. Pulp again? Wait, what? Molybdenum pulp. Right? And then concentrate. Pulp goes to concentrate. Concentrate goes to molybdenum pulp. Not it pulp, pulp. Pie, what are you doing, Pie? Okay, this is too cute by half. Agitator, concentrate, hydrocyclone, got it. Concentrate into the pulp. We need a thickener, I'm assuming just one. Thickener in quantity 1. And then we need disulfide in a filter. I got that, so we need a thickener. And we need filtration media. That's sad. That's going to have to be caravaned in. And then we need high-pressure furnace. So we need a thickener and a high-pressure furnace. And this is going to be a problem. Then that's just in the plate. And plates in an electrolyzer. So we need a thickener, a furnace, and an electrolyzer. So thick... Yeah. Fern. Yeah. Electrolyzer. Hey, I had all the stuff on me at just at start. That is as good. All right, so we can start setting this up, right? Oh, I'm not looking forward to dealing with sulfur. I'm gonna have to make it so that there is all sulfur goes into a caravan. No, the sulfur mine is still primary production, but I need to make a sulfur dump next to it that this will caravan sulfur into. And that it is used preferentially. But we don't really use the sulfur, is the joke here. yeah. I don't really do that. I suppose I'm going to start doing a lot with sulfuric acid very soon here. So maybe this problem will relieve itself. And we don't need much molybdenum anything right now. So it could be that this problem just isn't going to matter all that much. So, let us live in hope. All right, we can start laying stuff down. We don't have to go shopping. Jaw crusher. Jaw crusher shall go right there. And we will verify. I probably should just have walked slow. Yeah, jaw crusher. All right, you are to make iron ore. Molybdenum is bluish. All right, so there you go. And you are real fast. You are the fast step. So you will only get one row. So I'm going to leave the last thing undone, as is my habit. You need five each, so you need to be just completely full up of inserters, like so. And we need stone, like so. We have done this pattern many times before. And then just leave it. Then you head out, and you get dealt with. Okay. Good. Stone out accomplished. So now we come right here. And you are again going to need every single inserter that you got. You're coming down right here. And this too far. Actually, we already know exactly what this is gonna be. It's gonna be one of these, and we're gonna have gravel out, right? Ball mills. Actually, I'm gonna have ball mills be double deckered, because they take twice as much. So, like that. We're going to have a sorter, huh? So maybe this isn't quite what I want to do. I mean, I could be using long-handled inserters. In fact, I will. I will. I will actually do this properly. Using the equipment I have available. That's too close. There we go. Cut, please. Right there. Alright, ore goes in fairly large amounts. And then gravel will come this way. How much gravel you make? Not a lot. So gravel goes this way. Whitelist gravel. Nice thing about doing this so often is you eventually get quick. Gravel comes out this way. Oh, I guess we are off, aren't we? Alright, it's fine. There we go. Fix it, minions. And this leaves material out right here. We will do... How much material comes out? 10 molybdenite dust in 4 seconds. So you're gonna need three long inserters here. I mean, very well. I will do it. Well, it's gonna be tough to power these guys, right? With my current laziness. Molybdenite powder, right? No, we want... Well, maybe it's powder. Are you doing powder or are you doing dust? It makes dust, damn. Dust? Molybdenum dust. Alright. We're going to have to stick that right there. Make sure I pay attention to it. Okay, that is no guarantee whatsoever that I'll pay attention to it. That was a foolish statement. We're going to anticipate the future here. Actually, shouldn't I be anticipating the future here, too? Whatever. And right there. There, we are through the dust stage. Alright, what's next? Molybdenum dust. Dust now goes into pulp. No, it's time for the agitator. And they're going to need water in. And it's going to have a liquid in and a liquid out. So, liquid component is right here. That is water in. Agitator, finally. Now, finally exits my inventory. You have to make... That is a lot of material that has to be loaded in to a very small surface area. Like, this is an advertisement for fast inserters, isn't it? I guess this is how it has to be. And then, oh, I guess I should think ahead just a little bit, right? Right there. So, well, I guess we gotta, right? I guess we just have to. Alright. I do like that there's, like, physical incentive to using better and better gear. Like, it's just gonna be a giant pain to move your stuff if you don't use the faster, high-tech, more expensive inserters. That is good push and it is good pull. Molly, this is the hydrocyclone, right? Molybendite pulp and molybendium pulp. Yes, two completely different things. Hydrocyclone, and then after this, thickener. Hydrocyclone, which sounds awesome. Right there. You make tailings? No, don't make tailings. What? Oh. So you're only used for a few things. And you make sludge out. No. Wow, this is actually a little contemplated. So we have three liquids and then one out. So you, my friend, get moved down by like a lot, and I'll be back to you in a second here. So we have three liquids and then our outs are entirely solid. So right there. I will just declare this to be the problem. Okay, a problem is this. Yeah, it is kind of annoying. Alright, so never mind. One out has to be on the bottom. So pick up all that. And then obviously we have... No. Okay. Okay, obvious in air quotes. Right there. And then we need a... I'm going to have to go get more pipe. And we have one of our outs here. And that looks... That only sacrifices a single one, and we're producing a lot of material. All of this produces a lot of material. Alright, so now thickener, right? Thickener? Thickener then makes molybdenum. Molybdenum pulp. Molybdenum. Molybdenum pulp. And we have two outs. But the one out is the same as this out. So we should arrange for muddy sludge to be that way. And they're all a different shade of blue, which I really, really appreciate. And the outs are going to be one here, and then we need an in here. Right there. So what we need is to move one up so it's correctly spaced. That will get attached. One of these lines will be water. One of these lines will be the output. And I declare I have to get more pipe. This is output, so it means just water is just right there. And then, did I actually do this? I did not. There we go. They line up. Oh, that's good feng shui. That feels just nice looking at it. And I didn't connect this one either. Good, good, good. All right, we're getting close, right? We're getting close. Molybdenum. We have just made the second pulp. Now we need. All right, now we got problems. We're going to be caravanning the infiltration media. It's going to take the pulp and it's going to make the disulfide, and that's in a filter. Okay. So, first off, we need caravan. I don't know where it's going to be, so don't fuss. And caravan, we'll need this. Probably going to need more than one of yous. How long does this take? This is a 2 second crafting time. Wow. So the biggest problem here is going to be, wait, why do we have two? Oh, two inputs. So this is actually going to be irritating. Yeah, really irritating. All right, screw it. I'm not going to put them in the same line. It's going to use more vertical space doing it this way, but I'm going to be less annoyed right now. So that's what counts, right? Yeah, so that's the. Did I leave enough space? Yes. So just come down. No, wait. Then, like so. I think this should all be moved down by one. Right there. And this is how the fluid gets in, and it's gonna need the fastest inserters I got. And there's probably gonna have to be more than one of them. Yeah, we're gonna need two inserters just for this. So let's just assume. I don't even know what to assume here. Assume pain. Assume doom. Right, come here, dude. Add destination. Go over and hit the snack bar, and I want you to store food. Then I want you to go to filtration media land, which is right there, right? Ooh, this is gonna be a problem now, isn't it? I should probably look at that. Fill cargo. That's. They're in Struggle City right there. We're gonna have to work on this. And then I want you to come here and I want you to empty cargo. Right, so do this and I will be along. Because you're gonna have to be goosed to move forward. Okay, so we're gonna need that. This makes the molybdenum disulfide. Molybdenum disulfide, right there. And now we have to make that. So this gets made into condor core. That's a long way away. Am I going to be using this when I'm doing this? I don't recognize any of this stuff. So no, I'm going to assume no. I'm going to assume I'm going to replace all of this by the time I need this element. But anyway, we need a high pressure furnace to make the molybdenum trioxide. And this makes sulfur, which is a problem. And what I am going to do is I'm going to put this caravan right here, this outpost right here. No, wait a second. We are going to have to dual stack this right here. For what my plan is. Try not to gobble up space like it's absolutely free. Because it is not. Do not forget, it is not. There. You are now sulfur out. I suspect this is going to be a pinch point right here. Right here, and I need you to make that. And you are going to need help. Oh, and I'm out of circuit boards. Well, let's hope three is enough. Bam, bam, bam. All right, so. Actually, no, just to go through. How long does this take? 3 seconds. This is probably a bottleneck. I can't tell. And then right here, you are whitelist sulfur. And then you, this is our sulfur waste bucket. And it will be magically conveyed to the sulfur waste disposal by dinosaur. So, now we have one of our products out, which we will have to do something with, and we need a rail for oxygen. All right, so this is going to have to be oxygen. This is one product we need to keep. Molybdenum. So trioxide, and then you go into plate and electrolyte. So we're not going to do this. No, we are going to do this like I thought. Yes, this is 1, 2, and it has to be right here. That is the catcher for the seaweed juice. And then right here is the electrolyzer. And these guys got to fight for this right now. And you make molybdenum plate. Niobium, molybdenum. You're going to need hydrogen. And you output water. Weird. So that's got to be like that. And we have to have one line here, one line here. And out of pipe, so I have to go deal with that. Actually, that's not where I want it. I want one more down. And then this is our plate out. Here's where we plate out. And then it goes like this. And once again, we go to a caravan outpost. Where it will find its final resting place. All right. I am not sure I have confidence in any of this. Here, just everything goes in there. No, wait, you guys have to fight. So I guess that's kind of what I want. I don't know what I want. I'm going to want this here. I'm going to want this stuff primarily at the start for seaweed. And then at the end, I'll be doing something different, right? This is right. Just looks like it's too close. And this has to be like this. And it's got its ends, but those ends are not powered. Okay, now they're powered. And I am out of just about everything that matters, right? But this is the skeleton for it. So, let's begin. I gotta start putting in stuff. All right, so let's wire it out. First, our waste outs here, our mundane waste outs are stone and gravel. So let's drag over stone and gravel. We've done this a million times before. Here we got gravel. And this one's stone, right? No, that's sand. This one's stone. That one is real. This one is not. Alright, so stone is lower, so it should be on the outside. I'm not sure it even matters. Leap over for aesthetics. And then we join right there. Hooked up. Great. And then right here. Yeah, that's good enough. And then we leap over again for aesthetics. Oh, I should be doing it here, but I kind of screwed myself with the stone line placement, but whatever. It's going to work. Take this gravel away. So now, I suppose I don't even need this bus. I could be caravanning all this stuff. But whatever. Okay, so you, you're in, you're out. Lines out. You, you're in, you're out, lines out. We got plenty of hands. Everything's good here. Where do you, you put everything out onto this belt, and then this belt comes in like this. Okay, good to know. And it comes down, it comes here, you've got in, and now you need water. Water is this line. Water will then be right here, I declare. And I gotta go get pipe now, or else I'm not gonna be able to do this. And going next to that line might have been a mistake, but it's my mistake. Water line right there. Though I suppose there's push and pull on caravan efficiency. Like, it would be very nice. Oh, that should not be where it was. Not having to do all this infrastructure right here would be nice. But then you have to have the infrastructure. But then you'd have to program all of the dinosaurs to haul everything away. And I'm sure there's problems there I'm not even thinking about and haven't encountered yet. So maybe this is ideal. I gotta go get more pipe. I gotta go on a wander. And then should be able to get this going. I mean, fairly early into the play session too. Hopefully I will be able to get seaweed going. Seaweed is a vital link in my plans. So we have to go over here and get niobium pipe. Up, up. You can keep that. Up. This just, I have to remember, whenever I use niobium pipe, I'm using organic solvent. Oh, it's still waiting for a full caravan. Alright, I have to go up to filtration land here and spank the dinosaurs. And I'm going to have to consider, maybe, expanding this out. Like, is the problem the secret shopper is too slow? No, we don't have enough gravel in, it looks like. Yeah, gravel is the bottleneck. Alright, I suppose that's okay. Alright, so dinosaur number one, you have nothing. Dinosaur, you're both in the same position. My dudes, here, you, go to the snack bar, please. I have to take care of your buddy. And you, move on. Just move on. And I will manually fill the molybdenum filter hopper with this, but I'm definitely going to have to come back and try to figure out... Well, no, I'm bottlenecked on gravel. I'm bottlenecked on gravel. What can you do about that? Nothing. You can do nothing about that. Normally, the answer would be mine stone, but this game, you can, in this scenario, you cannot mine stone, which is a long-term problem for you. Okay, there you go. I will do a dinosaur's work. Not even put up that. All right, good. So, review again. You need water. Water out. Great. This comes right here. I need nitrogen and muddy sludge out. So nitrogen should definitely be right here. So where did I say nitrogen was? Right here, I believe. Did I actually finish doing the water? Yes, I did do the water line. Is there anything else I should have been paying attention to? Because I ran out of... I suppose it didn't run completely out, so maybe I didn't leave it finished. Yeah, I choose to believe that. Oh, big sad face. Oh, big sad face. And that's on... No, it's not on another line. Okay. That's okay. I accept this. I accept the complete humiliation of my present self by my past self. See, I thought ahead. But then I didn't think about thinking ahead. So not thinking didn't think the thought. No thinking thoughts. And everything turned out okay. Great story. Loved it. 4 stars. New York Times bestseller. Guaranteed. Muddy sludge? Still got a lot of muddy sludge. Really? Really? Okay, let's go over here. What can I do about my muddy sludge problem? I can always just keep electrolyzing it, but that is inefficient. So, a line for you is right next to this. There. A line for you. And here we are making more muddy sludge. It's fantastic. What would you do if you didn't have... if you took the perk, the upgrade, the quote-unquote upgrade that made the moss not need muddy sludge? I suppose you just vent this stuff, right? You would be in a world where you could just get rid of it and it wouldn't be a problem. But imagine that in hard mode. Oh my god, you need water too. Water in has to be right here. Thankfully, I have that. Bam. Okay, water in. No. Water in. There we go. Alright, sludge out, pulp over, pulp down to here. You're just a pile. Pulp in, you're ready to go. Put him in, coach. It's gonna come right here. You need oxygen, of all things. How fast is this? 3 seconds, that's fine. Oxygen. Which is not really expected. I don't know where to put this. Oxygen rail. It's gonna depend on a lot of stuff. So let's not make decisions. That's hot air. Hot air is doing fine. Always important to check on that. I'm surprised hot air hasn't become a waste product I have to get rid of by now. Oxygen. Oxygen's doing great. I salute you, sir. It's going for the coal. Yeah, it needs more dinosaurs. Okay. Good. Oxygen. Coming over. Not yet. Oh. And niobium production is birding right along, which is fantastic. Alright, so there is no real great place for the oxygen lines. Just put it wherever, right? And wherever is gonna be right here. Bop, 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 bop. Bop, 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 bop. Alright, so. And then. Perfect. Oxygen in. Now you have your requirements. We're getting very close to turning this machine on. And your vents are being vented. No, wait, you have to be... what is this? Molybdenum trioxide. Right there? Yeah. You need to be filtered or else we'll get a whole bunch of sulfur on this. And that's not what anybody wants. And this is kind of on purpose awkward right here. Alright, so we need hydrogen now. And water. Wonderful. Super thrilled about both of that. We're going to have to use a thing here, because this is going to have to join right there. Only obviously not using that piece. You need water in. Water in is boring to us right now. Water in. Yeah, feel like I've done something slightly wrong with this, but it's in line with everything else. But whatever. It's in line. Yeah, it would have been just the an awkward conflicts of outputs and liquid and solid production. So now we need hydrogen. I think hydrogen is down south, right? Comes in from the bottom. As glass, we don't have a lot of glass. We just are in giant cycles. Just caught. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. None of you are hydrogen, huh? I believe this was all just another hallucination. I love the little icons on the pipe. Factorio is such a well-designed game. It's so easy to see and do things. Which is, you know, very important for a game. So do I have to put in hydrogen anywhere else? No! Is hydrogen just new? It is a new ingredient for the processing area. I'm kind of surprised. Alright, so we have to go on a hydrogen hunt, and then we have to add it to the rail and bring it over. I am absolutely positively not barreling hydrogen. It shouldn't be allowed. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't work. It simply doesn't work. You get an empty barrel at the end. This is how you destroy hydrogen. You put it in a barrel and you try to do anything with the barrel, and then you end up with no hydrogen. Alright, so anything down here? We're getting into increasing long shots. This is organic solvent, right? No. This is world problems, right? Yes. And I'm just ignoring the syngas situation for the time being. Really, it went through all of those? Maybe it's not as efficient as I thought it was. I know we got hydrogen over here, so this is where we start. Yep, as per normal, setting stuff. I love that the flamethrowers produce pollution. I think that's just, it's very, very detail oriented. Yeah, so this is kind of our nearest hydrogen here on the grand boss. What? No, no, please tell me I didn't. Oh, they didn't connect. What are you doing, gasoline line? This looks intentional. Oh, am I using this for power? Did I make a mistake at some point? What is gasoline line doing? No, we're powering this off propane. We're not using gasoline here. What is that gasoline line doing? Is it a relic? I don't think I need gasoline for anything around here. Oh, and it had a ton of stuff in it. Well, that doesn't mean anything. Well, I think it does, actually. No, it's almost empty. What was the thought behind this? Was there any thought behind this? We're gonna just go out on a limb and we're gonna say no. And flush that. You are now a hydrogen line. For better or for worse. This is really suspicious and a very bad sign. Like, why is gasoline and hydrogen on the same, in the same rail at all? And then it comes down here, and then we definitely need that. This is definitely intentional hydrogen, and we definitely need hydrogen. So what was I doing there that I brought down gasoline? Was this a relic? I don't remember. I don't remember, and I'm confused. I'm so confused. doesn't make any sense. Everything all the time is so confusing. So this is going to be hydrogen lime. But I'm pretty sure everyone picked up on that. Bad news is this walkway gets a little worse. Which is kind of inevitable, right? Okay. Hydrogen line going over. This way. And then we're going to go quite a long ways, actually. So grateful for the niobium pipes. They make my life worthwhile. So this is the... There had to have been hydrogen around here somewhere, right? I'm totally duplicating infrastructure right now. Yeah, worried. Not really worried. Annoyed. Not really annoyed. Hungry. It's one of those things, right? Let me just get right here. Actually, I'm kind of hungry. Should do something about that. But here we are, halfway through the play session, and we are on the verge of hitting our goal. Wonderful. Put it in. And up and up and up, and you have your prerequisite, and you have water out. Oh, that's interesting. It's water out. So what I need to do is an underflow valve. And it has to be right here. Only add water if you need water. Then there will always be room for venting water in this pipe, and there's always water consumers, so it should always work. Alright, so, we're good, right? It's time to turn this thing on. So what we'll do is we'll start here, like we do. Add power. That's a bit much. Alright, so, that's a bit much. You need power too. No, you should have it from this. Alright, good. Make sure all the grabby hands have power. You do not have... You do have power. The building's small enough. All right, we're ready to go. We're ready to... One more line of poles, and then turn on. All right. Let's see what I missed. Go. Make a new creation for the factory. I'm going to... The rest of this episode is going to be starting seaweed and then cleaning this up. It has to be done. Aluminum's rare earth is next, and I need the space, and then aluminum after that. So it just... Wait. You're not doing it right. Oh, and it's going... What is... Okay, many bad things are happening here. This is getting out of hand. All right. You make... Powder. Whitelist. Powder. Alright, things are getting out of hand. Things are bad. But I can fix it. I can fix it. Shove the powder back in there. Great. I can reconnect you now. This is right. Alright, yes, this is correct. Alright, good. I'm probably going to need both ends of the sides of the belt there, which can be solved with multiple ball mills. Alright, so you're going. Recovered. We had a disaster, we then recovered. Okay, this stuff goes down, and this is the leading edge. It's going alright. Hydrocyclones, not... Oh, we don't have any inputs in. So we are not, in fact, ready for prime time. There we go. Loading it up. Oh, it takes a lot. Wow. This is definitely not a bottleneck right here. Bottleneck is almost certainly the agitator. Can I make another agitator? Or do I need to make an agitator? Circuit boards, melamine. You want me to go on a field trip for that? Oh, what's this? This needing to happen. Okay. So the agitator is doing just fine. It is inputs that are a problem, it looks like. I don't know. Watch it in a second. Oh, look, we made it through. Alright, so we are starting to make our first round of actual product. Well, product number one. The trioxide here is the seaweed juice that we need for seaweed 2. It's made deterministically, yeah? It's good. A whole bunch of it goes in the caravan. It's great. Maybe it should only be two arms in, then we'll split it halvesies. So the actual goal was just fine right here. Can you spring to life? No. No, we are not doing halvesies still. Oh well, whatever. This will eventually fill up. We'll eventually run out of filtration media. That's probably our bottleneck. We are definitely not gravel positive right now. The agitator is the bottleneck. I should probably address that. Yeah, I don't want to go get melamine. Probably make two more agitators. Alright, I will. So we have sulfur. Yeah, there we go. Molybdenum plate. We did it. Woohoo! Pop the party poppers. We have done good. Yes, we is have done good. So now we need some more caravans, and we have to set up sulfur venting properly, and I have to go make two more agitators. So let's go do that. And make an agit. I need steel plate, another hunk of small parts, got the glass, and then 60 melamine. Go grab caravans. Then head down, get melamine, build agitators, come back up, feel happy about self, award self one cookie. Yes, that is the correct way forward. So we run this way now. All this is fine. Everything is fine. We're going to have a lot of pressure on filtration media coming up. Because it consumes so much gravel, and it's needed for Xylopho, and it's needed for something else too, right? I've already forgotten. Anyway, all those things go directly into science. And science is important. Well, that's what they tell me in school, anyway. One brick melamine. Edges. One, two. You may have back the remaining melamine. I do not want it. Alright, so task the first, accomplished. Task the second, we are now on, it is called Do Something with Sulfur. Here is our sulfur mine. We consume very little sulfur overall. What an awkward place. It's like, how's the rock box doing? Oh, it's slowly filling back up. Okay, that's good. Not enough to slaughter any, but it is filling back up. What are you doing? High 5. Oh, you're bringing rocks to the rock box. That's kind of awesome. Let's watch him. And is that going to put him over the edge to have some rocks sent to meet the maker? I mean, I'm right here. They could have asked at any time. But at the same time, there's a different sort of maker over there. It's kind of an unmaker, really kind of a misnomer when you really dig into the details. But We shouldn't think about that too much. All right. So this is also powered by syngas, which is a highly restricted quantity now, resource nowadays. All right. So what we're gonna do, and we're even gonna balance this sucker. Yes. And I want input priority from the left. And it's probably also for it. Alright, dinosaur to me. Bam, dinosaur. I want you to go and I want you to get food for yourself. And I want you to come here. And I want you to No. I want you to go up here, take a long walk to right there, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I want you to fill your cargo. Then I want you to come here, and I want you to empty your cargo. There. That is sulfur taken care of. I mean, not really, because I'm not sure how much we're using it. I suppose I am also using it for bullets. But I'm making sulfur in a very inefficient process there, so that should probably be dealt with at some point. But I don't know. Everything is fine at the moment. Everything is going okay, he tells himself, convincing no one. Looks like glass is working again at full tilt. Wonder why. I didn't do anything. And up here, this is still going just fine. So that is hooked up. Oh, I made agitators. That is what I did. Oh, and I'm going to need more. I have enough. Thanks. No, I should place it manually. Agit. Bop, 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 bop. Like that. And now they share inputs and outputs. And then another one right next to it. Second verse, same as the first. Bam, bam. Then it's water, water, out, out. Now you need water. Water right there. Then we need to put a tag right there, a tag right there. We have to do that, do that. Now we're just good to go, eh? Now we should turn it on. There we go. Bottleneck be gone. It wasn't that backed up to begin with, so. This probably means that third one was not required, which is okay because it's not running right now. There you go. Yeah, they're getting more and more insistent. It would be really neat if they were ramping up, you know? Okay. Never mind. They already should ramp up. I've just hit the limit of the ramp at the moment, which is, you know, sad. It's always sad when you hit the end of the game. Alright, so this is perfect. And we're venting sulfur correctly. Perfect. Next thing to do, seaweed 2. This is deterministically made with seaweed, water, fertilizer, and molybdenum trioxide. And I don't... Where should I put this? Like, by a seaweed line, certainly. And then we will bring in... Here, let's take a look at a couple dinosaurs. Dinosaur 1 is looking at filtration media. Dinosaur 2 is looking at drill heads. And we will try and see what the future brings for both. The drill head one shouldn't be so bad, right? That car is going to have a museum built around it. Salt is a problem. Which means saline water is a problem? Yes. Alright, this should be addressed. Yeah, it should definitely be addressed. So filtration media is working. How many dinosaurs are here? I don't know. There's two dinosaurs here. That's the secret shopper. Here, and I'm just going to tell you to move with what you got. Only one dinosaur here. Alright, so you're doing alright. Let's go take a look. Let's run up here into what used to be the back of beyond. And let's look. Well, it's Americosaur keeping us safe. Alright, so we are now processing this for all it's worth. And I almost think we're running out of gasoline here. Which would be another problem. But yes, this is going maximum fast right now, because there's nothing being stored in the buffer. So I guess this is just how we live. Unless output priority to the right, which says you should go make saline water first. Niobium plate is a luxury. I believe in that division. But this means we are at the furthest extent of salty rock. Do we have another one? Phosphate rock. Salt. I should probably get this online and have this feed Niobium. Oh, more salt. That makes a lot of sense. And this continues to be saline water focused. Okay. I will do that, but not right now, because it doesn't matter. Niobium plate doesn't really matter. I mean, it does matter, because it gives me my favorite pipes in the world, but it is under no pressure at the moment. It's probably a more elegant way to put it. And I do not feel the need to build out that specific area of infrastructure at the moment. I have a whole lot more in front of me. Alright, just go. You're good. So the big problem here is loading time, it looks like. I am perfectly willing to help with. Be upgraded. So it needs 8 steel plates, and that's... Yeah, that is, unfortunately, should have had it come up across the top in order to have this. Oh, and look, and completely out, and so no niobium ore. All right, you have convinced me. We are doing something different. I will remake this slightly. Come across like this. And you buddies, be like that. Give me all these drill heads. Take all these drill heads, put them right there. And we will have truly a mark of good planning. The double line. And then so. Okay. So one fast and two slow. Is this enough to keep you going? Now we're titanium bound. Good. I can help that too. And if necessary, I can even make the actual fast inserter. I have everything. I can just click this button. It goes twice as fast. But doesn't look like that's super necessary. And frankly, all of this was unnecessary to begin with. Here, share. You gotta share. Some have to get through. You gotta share. Alright, so, good. We have accomplished a major goal. have gotten molybdenum online, and now it is time for seaweed and then cleaning. Fortunately, we must clean our room. Where is a good. Kind of don't want to do a seaweed line. I kind of want to do this next to the fertilizer and then not caravan any in. Just seaweed can just be made wherever. It's like it's not a problem at all. And this is a drip feed kind of thing. So where do I make fertilizer? I think I make it out of bones or something. Bone meal or something. Where do I make fertilizer? It's in the center, isn't it? That's where I found it last time. Everything good here? No, we are clogged. Why are we clogged? Lard. Why is that happening? Because this is just so slow. It remains oh so slow. This should be addressed. I'm not sure what I would do to address this. Like, I want to just make this work faster. Please just go faster. Lard. There's no. I don't need oleochemicals. No, absolutely not. Animal sample, workers' food. I mean, sure, but it's not a lot. Like, I mean, sure. And fish food and just compost. Yeah. I guess I just let this be for a bit. I came up here for a reason. The reason was trying to find a location for fertilizer. All right. We need manure. Manure isn't happening. Are you actually taking manure? No, I don't think manure goes in for this anymore. I think we get our carbon dioxide from wood again. Like, this used to be a very large carbon dioxide making facility, but not anymore, I think. What are you waiting on? You're waiting on fertilizer. That's the fertilizer factory, that's the depot. Okay. So, probably gonna have to do something about fertilizer, right? All you guys are generating as fast as possible. Which is, no. Why aren't you loading? Oh, because you're holding moss for some reason? That's super duper weird. Alright, anyway, we'll get the fertilizer situation sorted. Can't believe I'm poop limited. I have to look into this eventually. Maybe we should look into better ways of making fertilizer. Fertilizer. This is going to be more and more important coming up. This is expensive, but it does produce 10 each, and that's something. This looks really straightforward right here. This is probably the best one, right? Just seaweed. Seaweed makes biomass. Pipe in the urea. This is what we're doing right now, and this is probably the worst way to do it. And that's no. So this is just raw coal, which I have everywhere, biomass, which comes from seaweed, urea, which can be brought in. We should be doing this instead. Oh, it's completely backed up. What am I going to do about this? I have to find a way to get rid of all this lard faster. I mean, just practically speaking, that's another composter. So, I guess we do it, right? Build ourselves one, and we probably put it. It's so big. Ugh, probably put it right here. And we find that we make a spur line, we get over, and then we bring the cut. We find a way. Yeah, we just find a way, right? So we'll do this just right here. Even though there is no good way to put it. Oh, they're so big. Alright, so. Let's do it like this. We're even taking brains and making them go into lard now, because brain bin's full. Glorious. Doesn't need many. And lard goes in. Power goes in. There we go. And I feel a very strong pull to do fertilizer better. Maybe I should do that. Maybe it should be connected with the seaweed, because I'm also making seaweed. Okay, good, good. And our extra lard removal unit is now going. We are now removing another unit of lard every 3 seconds. Maybe this will get it moving forward again. Yeah, it's sort of moving forward again. And skin's overflowing. It's all overflowing, except for meat. Meat is in very high demand. In fact, we should probably increase the share of meat that's being collected. Don't want this running empty. Oh yeah, we're... No, wait. This is all just going to the augs. Alright, so that's fine. And now we're flowing again, and now this is better. The world is in a better place. Are we overflowing with blood regularly? We are. So I need to take this blood and do other stuff with it. Alright, so... Fertilizer. Fertilizer. Best thing to do for this is get some biomass and get some seaweed. And that's naturally right next to each other. Because this manure is the worst way to make fertilizer. It's just the worst. Though I should take whatever fertilizer I make and dump it in here. Just so everything is bridged together correctly and I don't have to redo anything. This area remains weird and effective. I will accept that combination. And then this is seaweed heading towards... No, this is seaweed out. The composter's over this way. The seaweed vent is down here. Okay. So we have biomass, we have seaweed. What we need is a fluidized bed reactor right now. But we have one. Isn't that wonderful? So lucky. Right there. Over in line with this. We are probably not producing enough carbon dioxide, and that is going to be an increasing problem, especially if I start stealing more to make fertilizer. But that is not something that I can help at the moment. Well, I'll be able to help it a lot once I get the next level seaweed online. Alright, so you go there. You go there. Here, give me a dinosaur. I need you to go do something for me. Add destination. You should probably go to the original snack bar. The classic Aug food. No, don't do that. Store food. Add destination. There, I think? Yes, there, but it's a struggle. So this is, again, a problem. Fill cargo. And then add destination right there. Empty cargo. So this is going to be a problem. We have a caravan outpost right here. And you make this fertilizer. Oh, it needs ash too. Oh, that's a problem, isn't it? Well, not really. You've got an ash generator right here, right? That's its purpose. So we'll just... How much ash do you need? 20 ash. That's a lot of ash. Oh, it's 2 per, so it's... This ash generator right here is just not doing its job. So let's make another one. Boiler. So boiler goes right there. And then now let's get some cheap pipe. To find a way to vent the steam. Again, cheap pipe. Oh, this is not good. I need more view. So we will have ash now. A lot of ash? No. Some ash? Yes. And this is a terrible use of space, but there's not much I can do about that. Okay, that's defeatist. There's plenty I can do about that. There's not much I'm going to do about that. That's the correct way to phrase it. Alright, so you're going to go right here. Straight over. And seaweed is kind of seasonal, isn't it? I'm happy to get small parts in my inventory. How rare it is that I'm happy to pick up stuff. Seaweed is going to be a problem, but I will make it work. I will add more seaweed to the system. That's what part this is all about right here. Seaweed Mach 2. I could be completely opportunist about this. And do this just literally right here. Probably needs a seaweed seaweed farm. Almost assuredly needs a seaweed farm. That would fit in right just fine right here. No, we need ash. There you go. And go for it. Just start making steam. Oh crap, you're not doing the smart thing, are you? You're doing the dumb thing. Why this happens, I do not know. Does not make sense to me. And the only problem is it's using up coal, sometimes even crushed coal. What I'd really love it to be doing is just vaporizing coal dust. Or using raw coal, even better. Actually, is this raw coal right here? Yeah, it is. No, it's coal. It is not raw coal. Alright. So this is the belt stripped of raw coal, which means it will have crushed coal and coal dust. And that's not so great. Alright, so fine. Sort of okay, right? In places, if you squint, aspects of this are okay. That sounds reasonable, right? Where is that? I need to dunk this in there. Perfect. Alright, so now we have nothing. We have to go pick the urea bot and find out what the problem is down in urea land. Hold on a second. Alright, back. What was I doing? Urea. I was going to go down and kick the ureasaur, and apparently, like, didn't just a few episodes ago I made an alternate source of urea? I'm a little confused. So, alright, so we have one ureasaur here, and then another one underneath him. Here. Go back to the snack bar. Oh, wow, tech actually happened. That's weird. And we are short on manure, and that's where we're getting this urea, so off you go, friend. Actually, where are you going? I should know that. Come here. Come here. He's faster than me. Oh, he's as fast as me. Okay, there you go. Where are you going? That doesn't help. What's this button do? Refocus? I mean, that's cool, but it doesn't really help. What I need to do is zoom out. I mean, it's nice, but it doesn't help. Well, this thing's completely dry, and that's a problem. So we don't have enough urea in the system. We don't have enough urea right here to even keep this going. So here, this will jog my memory. Wastewater, Xylopho wastewater was a huge amount of urea for us. And Xylophos aren't being slaughtered because shells are not needed right now. So let's go just take a look at that. I will take a look at this, don't worry. Don't let the flashy light overwhelm you. We will continue. This guy is picking up cocoons like it's going out of style. We are now bound on rock food, I think, but everyone's still going, so it's... No. We need to increase rock food, which is, again, we have to increase a whole lot of stuff. We need to find a use for shells and a use for arthropod blood. And there's this. Actually, we kind of do. Shell. Like, is it alright to vent shells? But the only thing I can do with a shell is primer. I'd love to turn it into lime. Just to, you know, keep this churning so I can use the byproducts. But no. Alright. You're done. Good job. We're gonna need that. So I think a primary problem was just not enough manure being produced. It was being used for It was being used for carbon dioxide, and it should not have been. And now it's being used for manure, and that probably shouldn't be that either. So, yeah, so I guess by pressing this button, I am committing to the new fertilizer schema. And that liquid manure should be urea, and then urea into fertilizer, instead of directly into manure, and then manure into fertilizer. That's going to be a lot more efficient, I believe. But we'll see. And you're going to go right there. Oh, they both did their jobs. And at least urea seems like it's fast. Alright. Okay, so this is... What are you doing? Oh, you're probably the one I sent over. Alright, it's fine. Let's take a look at this. What did we just get? We got the upgrades, and all the upgrades have been poisoned so far. We're not going to look at it here, though. Xylopho upgrade, data array upgrade. This looks more important. Whatever. Do Xylopho. And then these are the last two techs on this this tier. Let's take a look and see where the trap is. Upgrades. Seaweed. Unselect. Seaweed. What do we do? Improve pathfinding. Install better sensors and algorithms. The improved machinery will improve the harvester pathfinding, increasing production speed and energy consumption. So this is... I'm not really seeing it. The crafting speed appears to be the same. Yeah, the crafting speed is the same. What is the upgrade here? This takes decider combinators to make this, so it's extra math. But what does it give you? 3 times the speed, more energy consumption? It's not really reflected in the base item, is it? Alright, so just more, better, faster. No downside, really, except for power, and that's not a problem. So here we go. Real speed is plus 30%. Alright, sure. Okay, great. Seaweed calcium carbolization. Native seaweed crop has a useful relationship with common lime. Use calcium hydroxide as a growth medium for the seaweed crop. During the growth cycle, the lime fluids are either fully absorbed or evaporate. After the addition of carbon particulates, collect a calcium carbide remainder. Alright, so we get a recipe to make fine carbon dust. 2 fine carbon dust and slaked lime produces calcium carbide. So we get a slaked lime recipe. This just appears instead of having to be made with lime. Then we get slaked lime, and then we can turn it into calcium carbide. Produces oxygen and produces chlorine. So this is probably good. This probably will solve my acetylene problems for right now. And then over here, recirculation pumps. Install recirculation pumps into the seaweed crop facilities that will allow all water to be recycled for future harvest. So it just doesn't require water anymore. It just produces seaweed out of nothing. Not even saline water. I don't want this. So it really depends on whether or not I'm going to be using this recipe. I should look into this and actually do the math, because it's going to be a wild uncheck. Because I'd love to take just straight 30% more, you know? It's hard to argue with that. It's path of exile logic right there. But, yes. So, good. I'm going to have to think about that. I'm going to have to go up and stare at the acetylene maker. It's like, here, slaked lime. Slaked lime. It's used in... more than I thought. Huh. Huh. So this might actually be... oh, wow. Yeah, I want to say this is the correct solution. The other way of making slaked lime. And then I'd never do... well, yeah, this just... gets remade. Alright, I believe the extra recipes are correct, but I have to do the math on it. And then the other thing I want you to look at is lime, right? Lime? And lime's used everywhere. And lime can be condensed out of slaked lime. Yeah. I kind of believe in this. Alright, I'm probably going to get the recipe. The other thing I was going to do, I was going to run around, I was going to go check on my new fertilizer maker, even though we're doing okay here, but not great. Yeah, that's the best way to put it, I think. It produces a lot of fertilizer, 10 each, for 2 urea for 10, and we're full up here. This is a lot of fertilizer. And it looks like we're mainly bottlenecked on seaweed right now, which is fine. Like, none of this should be going to the composter right now. Go out right there. Alright. I believe in this. If I want more fertilizer, I stand up more seaweed. Okay, I believe. Now what we want to do is... nothing. Back in my pockets. We're going to link up this fertilizer to the other fertilizer, but not right now. Right now we're going to make a seaweed level 2 generator. That's the second goal for today. Alright, so I need a seaweed farm, right? I'm just gonna go rip one up. No, I'm gonna rip one out of the nickel processing area, or the nickel mining area, like I noted before. I noted that it was not what we needed anymore. Because it is firmly, like right here, this is not needed anymore. We are firmly inside the cordon. So I'm just gonna grab that and all this, obviously. And then I will use that, hopefully, to make our next level seaweed. So down, down, down we go. All right, new mission. Oh, you're even working at half speed. That's terrible. Yeah. All right, you are being retasked. New mission time. Everyone is always excited by new mission. Yep. Yep. Everyone is also excited by cleaning up logistics space. It is far less valuable now that I have a caravan-based system coming to just taking over everything. Still, it is good to be tidy. Okay, awesome. Plan. Why is this happening here? Oh, it's because it was necessary for making bigger, better trees or sap plants or something. I can't remember. I made a thing using the other things, and the things are still there, and I don't know what to do. Do I need the thing anymore? No, not the other thing. I mean the first thing. No, the second thing. I made the thing. I need to keep it. I don't know. Big. I don't know. All right, seaweed level 2. You actually need seaweed level 1 to do this? Oh, that's inconvenient, but also present. This is looking very jank right now. Very jank and very lazy. I mean, why do this right here, of all places? I don't have to. But, like, I'm gonna. We only need, like, that at most, I think. Alright, Sue. Now we're actually gonna have to use a longhander. Nope. Water in. Surely I have water around here, right? Because we're doing this with this. So turn your sprout upside down. And we will pack in water as best we can. There. Now you got water, and now we have only the other problem, which I have neglected to address. So what I should do is get another caravan. This is looking so jank. How much? We need 3 seaweed. This is looking jank as hell. I almost feel bad. I do feel bad. I feel bad doing this, but I can't stop myself. Alright. So, come on down. You get put in right there. And this other caravan is right here. Right there. Alright, Godzilla, I choose you. Add destination, food court. I want you to get food. Add destination. The weird oxide. No, not the electrolyzer. I guess it's you then? Yeah. I want you to. Till caravan has. This green stuff is a lovely green color. 500. Why is this stopped? Oh, it hasn't. It's just slow. Probably missing something. Add destination right here. Empty cargo. There. Go. Go and do. Alright, so I'm gonna throttle this back. And we should be ready, right? Here, this goes in there. That goes in there. Now here, make fertilizer out of this. Now we're ash limited. Well, it's coming along. Oh, I have to connect up the fertilizers, right? Well, do it now. Bam. Add destination. Original food court. Store food. New destination. Come here. Fill your cargo. New destination. Come over here into the mess. Right there, I think. Right there. Empty your cargo right there. There you go. Off you go. He's on a mission. How long does it take to do one of these? Pretty slow. Pretty ditty slow. That's fine. I need to go look at the oxides. Because that's where I just sent the Godzilla. And Godzilla might be staring there, gormlessly trying to pick up exactly what I asked of him. The system might be too slow to actually supply all of that. So, like that guy right there, just zoned out, staring at the og food bin, waiting to disgorge more, waiting. No, you here? No. It's just everything was a lot slower than I thought. Alright, so what's our problem right now? No, the problem is input. Alright, that's fine. That's cool. We don't even need this stuff. So it looks like I am going to need to do better on this, right? To add more miners. I saw that 3.5 seconds and I thought, ooh, wow. But looks like it's not that much. Do we have the mining drill? We have mining drills for days, and I love how slow it's consumed. Absolutely worth. Alright, let's go check out our secondary goal for the day. Then we will do a bit of cleaning, and then that will be it for this episode. Sap tree is completely full up. Excellent work there. Now we're going to have better seaweed. I really should put better trees in all of these places now. Like, there's no reason for this to be normal trees anymore. It'd be level 2 trees. This is continuing to be a problem. There are so many problems that need to be solved. Alright, so are we doing it? No, where'd the Godzilla go? There's no way I beat him back. Oh, I did beat him back. Wow. Bam. There we go. And you need how many more? 5 each? Okay, seaweed level 2. And this will be yet another major victory. Truly, we are marching, never stilled, to glory. And it's 100% chance. It's 100% chance. I love that. Bam. Seaweed Mach 2. Speed 200. Here, tell you what to do. Right there. Replace your brother. And now it moves even faster, and faster, and faster. Great. Great. Let's go check on the bees, right? This is a good time to go check on the bees, I think. And then just start picking up. We have the inventory for it. And then we'll wrap. Oh, that's interesting. You can almost not keep up. I wonder if the cycles come in pulses. All right, have we cleared the meat belt? Yeah, okay, good. I would hate to think it was going to waste anywhere. Okay, so let's go check the bees. Last time I was down here, the calc plantations look really nice. All of the pie alien life stuff is just top tier. Down to the Ulrichs chirping because he knew what was going to happen to them. Oh, wax. Wax is half full. Gonna have to do something about that. Probably just gonna get a bigger tub. Wait for tech in order to get rid of it somehow. I wonder if combs have a energy value. Comb. You have an energy value? No. Used comb. None of them have energy values. That's unfortunate. Hey, maybe I'll just make it part of the wall. Where's used comb? I guess there's no recipe for that. It's just something that happens to you. Anyway, we have here 280 bees just backed up. And in the queen chamber, we have seven queens, so we have an extra queen. Yeah, good. When it gets up to 10 queens, I'll flip the switch and turn it back into prioritizing. Oh, and it's finally gotten through its backlog. Prioritizing arquad production rather than queen production. And then later on, of course, as we get higher and higher tech, like, I'm convinced that the colony collapse upgrade is the correct one. Because the only downside is queens are 5 times more likely to die, which makes it hard to get started. But once I get higher and higher level tech, there will be less and less strain on the queen, which means the efficiency will just go up and up and up. And it will only get better. The extra wax and honeycombs will only... it is a dividend that will keep paying out, whereas the problems that I'm facing with the imbalance of queen lifetime to queen production, that will fade away. So, good. Now it's time to... The goal is to pick up all of this. Probably not going to make it, yeah. Probably going to have to move the bullet line somewhere. Having it coming through like this is just super awkward. Like, if nothing else, it should come down right here so at least it's straight. I think I'll probably do that. Yeah. So let's do this. Can I do this? Yeah. These guys only had 10 bullets in them? Wow. I had a lot of faith in those 10 rounds. No, don't do that. Being dumb. Always do the outer one first. Yeah. Continue picking up. Oh, that one too. And all these guys. Gotta come with me. There we go. And exit. This is not going to be the most thrilling content, but you know, I should probably fix the ammo line first. And we are... This is where I'm going to stop picking up right here. Everything else can stay. Alright. I have a ton of ammo in my inventory. And what I really want to do is we have... I guess we can follow this walkway. Just juke across and go on the other side and straight down, or just do like this, I suppose, but then it's going to be running into problems down here. Let's actually do a look at that. We are on a mission of aesthetic principle right here, so we might as well take a little time and see if we can see. Yeah, I'd want to have it too offset, and there, I don't have enough to leap, so our goal is right here then. This will be a new bullet line. I'm unclear whether I have enough belt for this. Isn't that embarrassing? Show up to build a factory and you haven't brought enough belt. An amateur error right there, if there ever was one. I need to go get more grenades. I don't think I've had to go in for any sort of shopping this episode. I haven't had to go pick up any materials for the buildings. I haven't had to go in and pick up more felt or more hands. It's kind of remarkable. All right, so that going like that, then this gets picked up. This is what's going to fill my inventory. So I'll have to go and dump that into the America bin. And all these bullets will circulate. I wonder how long it would take if I just went limp right now for the factory to fall. Like, they'll only have to breach one point, especially now that I'm taking down the secondary wall. It would be interesting what if I would have left this up, because the first place they're going to break through is right here, eventually, right? And then they'd get in here, but then they'd be curtailed by the secondary wall until they have to get down here, and then they'd spill over, or maybe they'd break through here first, or somewhere up here. Like, it's really unclear how it would proceed. It'd be an interesting simulation for, someone who already isn't on a long and exotic quest. So, I'm not gonna investigate that. I'm just gonna. Ah, there we go. Okay. Time to go to the America box. Let's just pretend I'm picking these guys up, right? Just pretend. It is gonna happen. There. Yeah, I feel like there's so much left to do still. I'm nowhere near done. And that honestly is a pretty good feeling, because I enjoy playing the game. How's the Yadals doing? Looks like we have no spores here. No fertilizer either. Yeah, it's a problem. But the Yadals are backed up, so it doesn't actually matter. Alright. This is a problem that needs to be addressed. America. America. Yeah, what would break first? Prodad, you will never get touched ever again. The item which is a imminent danger to you and your entire factory. Yeah, it's never getting picked up. I may want to snag that bitumen seep somehow. It's all going to be pumped on the other side of the wall, so I guess I would just try to play real quiet over there and make a anti-pollution screen around it. Here, why am I kidding? We're gonna be getting this anyway. Just go straight through. All right, so continue picking up evidence of American presence. Right there. Yeah, looks like it's completely stopped over in Molybdenum, that land right there. We'll be taking a look after I pick up all of this crap. And I'm gonna have to pick up all the way down too. Because it may stop here, but it doesn't really. It interferes with the rocks in a very unaesthetic way. And Well, we'll get there eventually. Okay. More bullets, please. There. And this doesn't belong in either direction. So I guess I might as well do this, eh? He says as he does this. Looks like the rock food is just full up here. But I should probably put these power poles back, huh? Before there is problems. Okay, pick up, pick up, pick up. We come to the end of the line. Internal lines, that is. Oh, hey, buddy. Is this messing with you? I will pull this down. Can't have my dino getting all messy. Or have bad pathfinding. So, he got enough rocks to go make a delivery, huh? That's good. So, it looks like everything, they have all the supplies they need. And so this is completely going, right? Yeah. Yeah, so this is working. We should have doubled rock production. I don't know if we can see that. Actual rocks, please. So it's still very jaggy for some reason. I'm not sure how to interpret this, honestly. So I guess it produces really well for a while, but then it runs out of a critical resource. We are in a productive stage right now. So what's the resource? It's whatever goes in here. Moss is not a problem. Rock food is not a problem. So what do you need? Coons. All right. That I understand. And that is a rock food problem. Or maybe I just need to build more cocoon makers. Not sure. Okay, we are at maximum American right now. Which means we have to haul ourselves back to the box. We will settle this issue. Okay, over here, up and up. So goal for next time is going to be rare earth processing. This is very advanced compared to everything else I've done. Then aluminum, because it has to happen, and then duralumin on top of that. I have enough naphtha to do proper rare earth production. Oh no. Oh yes. Give me a box. There you go. Americanness increases. So, I'm going to caravan over the ore, because I don't want to draw a line. I just decided I'm going to caravan. It probably matters. It really probably does. I should probably do a line. Just gonna argue with myself back and forth over that. I think I'm probably gonna do it, right? Maybe. I don't know. We're not stopped. It's the same thing as before. It's just too little ore coming in. And so this pulse is really hard. Yeah. And a lot of it ends up here. Let's not care at all. We don't care even a little bit. Just let it dribble in. That's all that's needed. I was way down here and I was picking up a bullet line. I should continue doing that. And now, I'll continue correcting this. There's no need to stop. Biakuas. Oh, and we will leap aesthetically. And we will leap a little less aesthetically, but we will leap. And right there. What's this doing? There we go. That's a proper corner. All right. So, bullet line is fully working now, which is wonderful. It keeps us defended. But I wonder if they'll even ever break through here, this bottleneck right here, in a meaningful way. Because I guess the key would be knocking out all of these flamers. Like, I don't know if they could the AI would even hit these, but I mean, probably just distracted by the closer ones. I really wonder what would be first. I would almost be tempted to put the game at like 1,000 speed just to watch it, but I don't believe that option exists anywhere. So we will start rolling this all back from right here. And we must not clip that. This is... Oh, that's a fair amount of gasoline that's going to be wasted. Alright. Time for the great picking upping. We'll roll this back. Is this the fastest way to do it? I do not know. It's reasonably fast, though. This section, let's go. I wonder if the bots are helping or hurting when it comes to these little, picking up the wall segments. And they certainly erase that, so... But they also aren't picking up the ones I have them here for, which is the gun turrets. I'd much rather they be picking up those. Those are the harder pickup times. Or longer, rather. It's not exactly rocket science. See a thing with X. Put a thing in X in your inventory. Congrats. Go find another X. Okay. Cleaning continues. Good. I don't like using logistic bots, because like I keep saying, geometry is the final boss of Factorio. Honestly, caravans are probably even kind of bad. Given how easily they hook things up and allow you to bypass geometry. The game's at its best when you're trying to route spaghetti. The fight against spaghetti should continue, always. And logistic bots allow you to bypass that, and honestly, so do caravans. So, it's a little unfortunate in my opinion. I suppose people just don't like doing that same, routing and organization puzzle over and over again. It might be why you're allowed to grow out of it with bots and trains eventually. But anyway, regardless of the merits of logistic bots, construction bots are just brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. I understand why people say they can't play without them. I rather enjoy the process of earning them through technological process, so every stage has weight. And it feels like you are slowly getting stronger all the time. But at the same time, I understand why these little guys are so useful, you can't live without them. Makes sense to me. Alright, pick up again. We have erased a good bit of wall. Actually, we're about halfway done. Yeah, I'm going to finish this. Then I'm going to deposit all of the materials. I will go check on Seaweed one more time. Make seaweed go faster. Make better seaweed go burr. And then I'm going to call it after that. We'll just be done. Tomorrow, rare earths, which is going to be a ride. Probably not so bad, given that I already have all the buildings. I just have to uproot them and then deal with all the idiosyncrasies of the production line, of which I'm sure there are many. Like, niobium takes organic solvent. Oh no. That stuff is worth more than gold right now. Though, if I want to get out from under that bottleneck, all I have to do is handle petroleum refining. Just actually refine the crude oil correctly, make cumene, vent everything else into steam, and then I should have organic solvent just for days. It'll just completely obliterate the rubber bottleneck. And also give me something to do with the Xylopho blood. The problem is I'll be bottlenecked on shells then. I will be bottlenecked on shells. Shell. Yeah, the only thing can be done with that is primers, and it doesn't use many. So we're going to be bottlenecked on shell for a long time. Until I can find a way to properly vent that stuff. I suppose I could be slaughtering Zapirs. Arthropod blood. Zapirs give 65. Xylopho give 80. Arquads give a little. I should be doing that too. So I guess between Arquads and a couple Xylophos every once in a while, I should have all the arthropod blood that I need. But it's always going to be a kind of balancing act. It's a secondary product, so I want to overproduce it. And then establish a vent system, like with the lard. Okay, almost done. Oh, almost out of inventory. Very convenient these two things are happening. I also have to remember to pick up grenades. Put that on the grocery list. Get grenades. Okay, perfect. Couple more segments left. I must be careful not to go completely over on inventory at this point, because these guys would just hover over me nagging. And I would prefer that not to happen. Okay, this is it. That didn't take long at all, did it? This area is now completely cleaned up. Beautiful. We're gonna go deposit all this stuff. And then we're gonna go look at seaweed. And then we'll be done. We're gonna complete this walkway. All the way to the end of the line. There. Yeah, so right here is rare earth. Right here is aluminum. We don't really have room for titanium or literally anything else. So I guess I'd have to push out and then do it northwise, you know? There's no reason why it only has to be down. It could be going up as well, though I also don't want to build on top of the copper ore patch. But we'll see. I think there's just alloys in the next tech tier, and then after that, the tier is artillery. And that's just, congrats. You have all the space you could ever want. So good. The plan continues. I follow the plan. I trust in the plan. How are we doing on saline water? We're back up and pressurized, so that's good. Okay, on the to-do list also is to go and figure out lime acetylene is the main problem why I can't get enough lead to go into a full propene economy. So it might be worthwhile to do that sooner rather than later. Is there anything else? Oh, all this and that. Anything else? Just leave myself in kind of a neutral position for now. Grab some grenades. Never have too many grenades. Actually, I'm going to refill my repair packs while I'm also up here. I have enough belt to grab more arms while I'm here. Grab more basic piping. Hide this asphalt. There you go. Hidden. No one will ever know. So over here, grab some pipe, grab some inserters. Americosaur, keeping us safe. Bop, bop. Yes, thank you. Refresh this. Yes, thank you. All right, last thing is to run over and check out seaweed, and then we're done for right now. And we can look forward to first refining rare earths and turning it into all the ingredients of artificial blood, then make artificial blood, and then we will have everything we need for Corlexes, right? I think that's true. Alright, so this is going okay. I believe in this more than the other one. And I believe in this a lot. This is nice. Then here, take this. Turn it into... make the five of them fight to make a better one. So these are... this is now moving at double speed, so this spits out a new one every 12 and a half seconds or so. No problem. And that is... here. Let's go be the seaweed fairy. We have seaweed... problem is I don't have a centralized seaweed... right there. That's probably the closest thing I have to a centralized seaweed production facility. So let's head over there and let's double some weed. And then that shall be it. Okay, can I get through here at all? Bam, 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 bam. Bam, and bam. Rest just goes out. So this now is at 1.9 speed, which we're going to call double speed. And this goes for 50 seconds, so it's instead of one seaweed every 5 seconds, it's now one every 2.5 out of this, which is completely fabulous. In other news, this is going all right. The meat processing is now doing just fine. That there's two ways to get rid of lard. All of this is various stages of okay. And the pooping continues. All right, on that happy note, oh wait, one more thing. I want to go look at the fertilizer area. Just nothing is making up here, right? Just absolutely nothing. Because we are making liquid manure first, and it's all going here. Yeah, it's all going here, and then it goes into liquid manure. Why is this manure going here? Why is this going here? Like, is it making urea directly? That would be the reason, right? Yeah, okay, it's making more liquid manure right here, and then it's doing this on site, so, okay. Then what's the other one doing? Hmm. No, serious question. This makes a lot of urea. And a little urea makes a lot of fertilizer. So that's actually a really good question. What is this other liquid manure area producer doing? What could be using it? Oh, depolymerized organics. Oh, okay. Actually, are we getting low on this? Not really, no. Huh. Well, it is definitely good then that this is all going for that. Alright, I am now done. Alright, see y'all around next time. Another great success today. Tomorrow we shall be even more successful. So, bye now, bye-bye now, bye-bye-bye-bye, bye now.